see. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. Our finest gifts we bring. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. To lay before the King. Ba-rum-pum-pum-pum. Rum-pum-pum-pum.
So much, worship team, for leading us in that song. Personally, that's one of my favorites. Now, I just want to say thank you to everybody watching in and tuning in for our Christmas Eve service online. Just want to say welcome, whether you're watching on your couch with your family, maybe you're in the drive-thru. Just want to say welcome. We're so glad to have you. Let's go ahead and read this passage of scripture together out of the book of Luke as we continue in worship. You'll see it on the screen. Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly hosts appeared with the angel praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom his favor rests." Now let's continue to worship together.
Joy to the world, the Lord is born. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him a room, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven and nature sing, and heaven. Let men their song. so brightly shining. It is the name of our dear Savior's birth. And only the world and sin and error pining till he appeared in the soul felt his worth. Oh, a thrill of hope in the weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. And when Christ was born, when Christ was born, and truly he taught us to love one another, his Lord. His gospel is peace. And chains shall he break, for the slave is our brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease.
Oh, we believe. Sweet hymns
and sweet hymns. Praise you.
want to say thank you to the worship team for leading us in worship tonight. Welcome to our Christmas Eve service. Tonight we are celebrating the birth of Jesus, the Prince of Peace, the Lamb of God, the Emmanuel, which means God with us. Over the past couple of weeks in church, we've looked at the journey home to Christmas. We talked about the shepherds, how they looked for Jesus. We talked about Joseph and his role. We talked about Mary and the baby Jesus. And this coming Sunday, we're going to talk about the wise men who still seek him. We have I have personal memories of Christmas. I think we all do. Church programs, family gatherings, maybe family fights. Not all memories are good. I remember as a child going to Christmas Eve service or Christmas Day service, depending on when Christmas hit, and we would always get a stocking filled with candy, and there was always like some walnuts in there and an orange or an apple and then some candy. I'm not sure whatever happened to the walnut or the orange or the apple, but I went for the candy. But we all have those memories of Christmas. The Christmas story is found in the Gospel of Luke. I want to read that for you tonight as we are celebrating this Christmas Eve. And Luke talks about the birth of Jesus. So if you want to get your Bibles out, you can follow along with me. Luke chapter 2, I'm going to read 20 verses, verse 1 through verse 20. Follow along with me if you would. In those days, Caesar Augustus decreed that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This is the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to his own town to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth to Galilee in Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and the line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born. She gave birth to her firstborn son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no room for them in the inn. And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord showed around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You'll find the baby wrapped in cloths, lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of heavenly hosts appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace to men in whom his favor rests." When the angel had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in a manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what they had been told about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which we have just been told about. It's a simple scene. You think about the Christmas story. Pretty simple scene. This first Christmas, you have this couple in a room, this young couple in this room by themselves, really like a cave or a stable. They're in this room. There's a feeding trough there, and there's a little baby in that trough. It was probably cold. They were away from home, so I just think through how they must have missed being with their family. Not exactly what we might call the Hallmark moment. You know, we like to watch these Hallmark movies during Christmas. At least some of us do. And they have all these scenes where everything works out, everything's perfect. This wasn't exactly one of those Hallmark moments. This rustic scene marked one of the greatest events in history, if not the greatest event in history. God's Son became human. He came to earth to save us. God had promised to send the Messiah, a deliverer, to deliver us from our sins, one that would save his people from their sins. He could have easily burst onto the scene as this full-grown man, 7 foot tall, big, massive, triumphant king, but he chose to come differently. He chose to come as a baby in a lowly estate of a manger. That's how Jesus showed up. Now, he's going to come back someday. He's not going to come as a baby, but he's going to come as a triumphant king someday. He arrived here in the arms of a young girl in that manger. Somebody once said, this very small package wrapped in rags, given from the heart of God, the perfect gift. Let me read that to you again. A very small package wrapped in rags, given from the heart of God, the perfect gift. Christmas is the earthly start for Jesus to the cross. It's where he entered humanity for the express purpose of sacrificing his life for us. God gave his only Son to die in our place so that we, in our brokenness, could know forgiveness for our sins. He came so that we could know what love really feels like. Real love. Love that never leaves. Love that never disappoints. Love that never betrays us. Wouldn't you like to experience that type of love? That's what Jesus brought to us. He sent his Son into a corrupted world to bring us hope. Some of you tonight, as you're watching this, feel hopeless. Some of you feel lost. But let me tell you this. Jesus Christ is the hope of the world. Jesus Christ came that very first Christmas to bring us hope and to show us who God is so that we could see him. My hope for you this Christmas Eve is that you know the true hope of Jesus. We might be asking, how do I know that hope? Well, if you're not a believer tonight or you've never accepted Christ as your Savior, you know that hope by saying, I know I've sinned. I know I make choices that are not godly or not right. And I understand that I can't be good enough to take care of those sins. And so you say to Jesus, Jesus, forgive me of my sins. And the moment you say that, Jesus Christ, the Son of God, through the power of the Holy Spirit, comes to live within you. If you're going to pray that prayer tonight, I want to pray it with you. Pray this with me if you would. Heavenly Father, I thank you for loving me. I thank you that you sent your Son Jesus that very first Christmas so that he could live a sinless life and he could go to a cross and sacrifice himself, the perfect lamb, to take away my sins and the sins of the world. And I receive you tonight in Jesus' name, amen. If you prayed that prayer tonight, you said, I've given my life to Jesus Christ, in the comment section, there's a place that you can click, a link that you can click, and we'd love to give you some information about how to continue your walk with Jesus.
Thank you so much for sharing that with us, Pastor Brad. Now we're going to read out of Isaiah chapter 9, verse 6. For to us a child is born, to us a son is given, and the government will be on his shoulders. He will be called Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, and Prince of Peace. Now we're going to go back into a time of worship. Won't you join us?
Come, all ye faithful. Let's read from John chapter 1, verse 14. The Word became flesh and made his dwelling among us. We have seen his glory, the glory of the one and only Son, who came from the Father, full of grace and truth. Let's continue to worship.
Hallelujah. Christ the Savior of the world, He has come. Alleluia. Alleluia. To
Let's read from the book of Matthew, chapter 1, verse 23. The virgin will conceive and give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel, which means God with us. Let's continue to sing.
Oh,
Thank you so much for joining us for our Christmas Eve online service.
And on behalf of us here at Refinery Church, we want to wish you and your family a very Merry Christmas.